Hey, check this out. We're cruising through a red mangrove forest deep within the heart of Cuba. Let's go explore a Caribbean paradise today on the Great Outdoorsman.
The Great Outdoorsman is sponsored by Ford, built Ford tough. Walmart, we sell for less every day. Rapala by Normark. Penn, dedicated to the sport of fishing.
Arriving at Mia Cayo Coco in the evening is truly spectacular. The wide open concept, bar and band in full swing, and gracious staff waiting to aid you in your every move. But it's when you wake up in the morning that the true experience starts. A beautiful walk on the white sand beach, buffet breakfast, and then to the pool. There seems to be a lot of activity going on at the resort, which is great. Hey, you can get involved if you want, or just sit back, sip on a tasty beverage, and enjoy the scenery. The Mia Cayo Coco is just one of five all-inclusive resorts located within the boundaries of the Coco and Guillermo Keys, and offers just about every holiday amenity possible.
Well, we're standing here poolside at the beautiful Mia Cayo Coco, an unbelievable five-star resort here in Cuba. You know, one of the things I've noticed about coming to a resort like this is a lot of times when people arrive here, they stay right inside the confines of a resort. Not that that's a bad thing, because there's a lot of great things to do here, but today we're going to go on an adventure. We're going to go to a national park, and we're going to see some of the great flora and fauna that Cuba has to offer. My tour guide for today is Hector Danielle, who is an employee of the Sol Mia Corporation. How are you today, Hector?
Fine, and you? I'm very good today.
Excellent, my friend. Now, maybe you can just give me a bit of background and tell me why you are going to make a great tour guide for today.
Okay, I finished university in 1988. I studied biology in Santiago de Cuba. I was getting practice in Havana for 1 year, and I started to wear in Cayo Coco in 1990.
Maybe you can tell me a little bit about where we're going today.
We are going to a natural area to see the forest here, the beaches, stone lagoons, birds, a lot of things that you can see out of the hotel.
Dynamite.
One of the best ways to round out an all-inclusive vacation is to go out and explore. And as Hector and I cruised down the sandy key roads, I was amazed at how different the landscape was. This is one of the added attractions that you can find at the Sol Mia Resorts. The resort will help you with maps and scenic destinations. All you need to do is bring your imagination, a camera, and somebody to take a picture of.
Now, Hector, as we're walking into the park, a truly remarkable sight. And I think that the thing that's most interesting is I look around, I don't see any hotels or anything for miles, just lush greenery.
Yes, in Cayo Coco, the government has made a program to develop for tourists all the area. And this area all the time has been reserved for a national park. Here you can find a lot of scenes, very interesting scenes. For example, the second highest sand dunes in Cuba are here. The first are in Pilar Beach, in the other key. Here you can find almost all the birds have been recorded for Cayo Coco. Cayo Coco has the first record in Cuba with almost 220 species of birds. And you can find a lot of them here, around here. You can see different kind of forests on the sand dunes, forests, evergreen forests, mangrove forests.
Well, talking about forests, this looks like a good one up here. Why don't we start with this one? Because I can't believe the size or the density of this forest. Wow, Hector, this is incredible. I say that only because it looks like something tropical, maybe something out of the Gilligan's Island kind of a thing. Mm-hmm. But is this what you would typically call a forest?
No. It's not a typical forest. In Cuba, it used to be another kind of farm near of the coast.
Yeah.
And this region, and this archipelago, the King's Garden,
yeah,
we can find this kind of palm. It's different. It's a Cocotrinas tree.
Yeah.
And this forest is unique on this region, because in other places you can find that kind of tree, but not like a forest, all together, a lot of trees together. And here, it's a big forest of Cocotrinas tree.
And mixed in, you have other species of plant, or does it basically...
Basically, it just
covers it all over.
Yes, Cocotrinas.
Okay, and what would they use this for? Anything? Is it of any use to anybody?
It can be used as an ornamental plant.
Yep.
And the pigs can eat the fruits on this kind of plant. And some very high the plant can use it as a, how do you call it, stick for,
yep,
for fences,
yep,
for example.
Did you ever see that movie, You've Got Mail? Where this guy and girl fall in love emailing each other a bunch of times? Anyway, they finally meet face to face, and there's this big romantic kiss. Do you know the movie I'm talking about? Did you ever see that one? Well, this guy didn't. Ford F-Series Super Duty. Built Ford tough.
Not so fast, Ledbetter. You missed one small detail in your plans to conquer the world. My couplings. Inside each is a cold fusion chamber with enough power to activate the death beam in my fountain pen. And your evil sidekick is then cut down to size.
Over 300 movies per month on Roger's Digital Hero. Where will it take you?
I think he wants our hats.
I'm not giving him my hat, I just got this hat.
I want your hats! Give me your hats! Score your own hat trick in every specially marked pleasure pack case! You get 12 exports, 12 Canadian, and one of three collectible hats!
How did we get a penny?
I don't know, but these are great seats!
I am Canadian!
Is there something in particular? Something that you
CTV Sportsnet Ontario, home of the Raptors.
This silver chalice is filled with guts and glory. This week, we've got Lord Stanley's Cup, Be a Player, The Hockey Show. Tonight at 7 on CTV Sportsnet Ontario.
The Cuban peewee is a bird that you can find in our Caribbean area, and we call it lesser intelligent. You can be close to them and they never go.
As we've been walking through the park, the one plant that I keep, I want to say plant, but it's not really a plant, it's more like a tree or a forest. The one plant that seems to be the most popular, the most densely populated, is the sea grape that you keep calling. It's everywhere.
In Spanish, we call it uva caleta.
Uva caleta.
The Latin name is Cocoloba ubifera. It has fruits like grapes.
Yeah.
People used to eat them, the fruits. And it's possible to make wine, a kind of wine with the fruits. You can find these trees along all the Cuban coast. Sometimes they form as forests,
yep,
near off the coast.
Well, that's the one thing I've noticed, that in some areas it grows very tall, like trees, and in other areas it's like bushes.
It depends on the ground and it depends on how old is the tree.
Right.
Some areas you can find the mangrove forest, and in the areas where the land is high, the coast is higher than the mangrove areas, you can find the uva caleta, the sea grapes.
Sea grapes?
Yes, forming forests, protecting the coast from the air and the salt that comes,
yep,
with the air to inland. In Cayo Coco has been made several ecological paths.
Yep.
This one is the path of the dunes of Coloma del Puerto.
Okay, when you say ecological path, you mean?
Ecological path.
Okay, so it's like, yeah, okay.
You can go into the forest, see different trees, different animals, and different scene of the relief.
Yep. Okay. So, and you said there's a good looking lagoon over here that we're gonna hit?
Yes,
okay.
It's a very good lagoon.
This is incredible, just walking,
yes,
through here. Almost looks like the basis of the ocean. So Hector, you mentioned that this is a saltwater lagoon.
Saltwater lagoon, near of the coast.
Does that mean
it has communication with the sea?
Oh, okay, yeah.
And when it's raining, the water comes from here, and it mixes sometimes. And here it's possible to find a lot of birds during the migration season.
Yeah.
A lot of ducks, coots, egrets come here for feeding and to rest the day.
It's interesting, sorry to interrupt you, the amount of light that you can find in such a small little area right off of the ocean, because I imagine that it's much more fertile, like you said, the fertility brings the birds in and then it's just kind of like a cycle. So very interesting. How deep would the water be out here?
Not so deep.
Shallow.
Never is 1 meter deep.
All the way across, eh? So just a shallow flat?
Yes, flat. And sometimes with a lot of rain, the level can be
all the way up
into
the trees. You know, Hector, one of the things that always fascinates me is a plant's ability to live just about anywhere. And here we are standing on solid rock. They're so adaptable, aren't they?
You know what? During the rainy season, the level of the water can be higher.
Yep.
And some plants can resist to have the roots in the water.
Yep.
And not just the mangrove can grow near of the lagoons.
And it's incredible. They seem to run all around through the rocks. Anytime there's a crevice or an opening, a new root springs up. Just a very adaptable plant. Hector, I thought it was pretty interesting before when you were talking about the dynamics of Cuba as a country and how it's situated with its northern part in the Atlantic and its southern coast in the Caribbean.
All the north coast, you can find very good beaches.
Yeah.
Because it's facing to the Atlantic Ocean. And to the south of Cuba, the coast is higher. And there are very good bottom for scuba diving, but there are not a lot of beaches very good. Even if when you find other keys to the south of Cuba, the beaches are to the north, and to the south you can get only mangrove areas.
Yeah,
that is a characteristic of Cuba.
So Hector, we're on our way up to the dunes, which, when we were up on the top of that the Dog's Tooth Rock, you could see in the distance. Very impressive sight. I'm sure that when we get up to the top.
Yes, we are on the sand dunes, the second highest sand dunes, I told you.
Yep.
Loma del Puerto sand dunes, we call it. Here you can see a beautiful landscape. On the top of the sand dunes, you can see the beach, Loma del Puerto beach. You can see the ocean. You can see the forest. You can see the Cayo Coco from the top of the dunes, and a beautiful lagoon that is behind the sand dunes.
I can hear the ocean on the other side. Just saw it peeking around the corner there, and I'm expecting a good view. Look at this. Oh man, this is spectacular.
Yes, it's very nice. I remember the first time when I came here, it was in 1990.
Yeah.
I became crazy.
Yeah.
Yes. I ran all over the sand dunes to over there. Yes, it was incredible to me.
Oh.
Even to me to see this beautiful landscape, the beach, the sand dunes, the lagoon, all colorful. It's very nice. I like it. Very.
Well, you know, it's very impressive, and it really sums up why you need to, you know, get out from the resort and see a lot of the things that are here, because this is a beautiful country. Standing on the end of this peninsula out here, you see the land jutting out into the ocean. You got ocean on all sides, and like you say, you can see for miles. There doesn't seem to be anything around here.
From here, you can see the flat land of Cayo Coco. Over there is the Bahama Channel. And sometimes there are a lot of rivers in the lagoon.
And just to think about how long it would take to make these sand, it's just
it's a thousand and thousand years. You know, the sea, the stream of the sea brings the sand from the sea, from the bottom of the sea. And the air take all the sand out of the beach. And the grass can keep all the sand together. and it's increasing every year, a little bit. All the roof of the plants keep the sand together. Yep. That is why it's important to conserve the vegetation on the sand dunes.
Well, it truly is a paradise, there's no doubt about it.
I'm always prepared and properly outfitted for the great outdoors. Before I head out, I stop at my friendly neighborhood Walmart store. Just look at these great items.
Like the Abu Garcia C1000 S3 spinning reel. It's equipped with a smooth front drag, instant anti-reverse, it has three ball bearings and holds 175 yards of 6-pound test. It has a one-piece graphite body and is ideal for all-round fishing.
Walmart. We sell for less every day.
Sweet taste comes from honey and nuts and the goodness of Cheerios. Honey Nut Cheerios.
With MSN Messenger service and your MSN.ca homepage, you can talk online with your friends and family by text or voice, all in real time.
What's flambé?
It means to set on fire.
How much salt?
Just a pinch.
Thanks, Mom.
Oh, and if you really want to impress her, don't wear that flowered shirt.
Wow.
Did you ever see that movie, You've Got Mail? Where this guy and girl fall in love emailing each other a bunch of times. Anyway, they finally meet face to face, and there's this big romantic kiss. You know the movie I'm talking about? Did you ever see that one? Well, this guy didn't. Ford F-Series Super Duty. Built Ford tough.
Saturday mornings, CTV Sportsnet is home to Fish On with Leo and Steve.
Fish On! There we go!
This is what we call musky fishing here.
Each week, catch the hottest action on water with two of Canada's best pro anglers. When it comes to fishing, these guys are serious.
Thick fish. Kissing cousins.
Well, not that serious.
There you go.
Fish On with Leo and Steve, Saturday mornings on CTV Sportsnet.
Estoy tan enamorado de la nena como está, que cuando se va de casa, qué triste me pongo. Estoy tan enamorado de la nena como está, que cuando se va de casa, qué triste me pongo. Ay, ay.
Entonces, mejor cogemos por este canal de acá.
Well, Hector and I have arrived at Lake Redonda, and this is an international bass fishing center. Now, normally there's supposed to be a lot of bass in this lake, but recently the water levels have gone way up. The pH has changed, so the bass fishing is very tough. Anyway, Hector's arranging with the owner of this boat to take us back to a mangrove patch that's way at the far end of this lake.
So, Hector, give me a little bit of background on this lake. I mean, it's a monstrous piece of fresh water, and like you say, it's like tucked in right into the middle of the mainland of Cuba.
Yes, because there is an area, it's a wetland, where you can find a lot of lagoons. Even we have to the other side the biggest lagoon in Cuba, and several channels where you can go to the sea. The water from the rain come here, yeah, and mix with a few with the salt water from the sea. That is why we can find here a lot of mangrove.
So we've got saltwater tributaries coming into here?
Yes.
Unbelievable. And here we are coming into this the mangrove tunnels. I mean, look at this stuff. Boy, I tell you what, Hector, I am just overwhelmed. I feel like I'm in the Amazon or something. What the heck is that? Looks like
a termite nest.
Termite nest. Look at the size of it. Now, what kind of mangroves are these?
Red mangrove.
Red mangrove.
The red mangrove can grow into the sea. After that, you find the white mangrove and the black mangrove. Both,
as you move in,
or just one.
As you move from the sea in towards land, that's the progression?
No, the progression is into the sea.
Oh, okay, I see. I was going
between the root of the mangrove, and can accumulate detritus, leaf, a lot of things. From the branches, grow the air, the roots,
right
into the water.
They just keep moving out and out.
Yes,
and out.
Moving.
It's almost eerie in a way, to be honest with you. I mean, it's. Give me an idea why the water is so dark colored, like a tannic color.
The mangrove forests are one of the most productive ecosystems in the world. There is a lot of flora and fauna between, in the water, between the branches. There is a lot of insects, arachnids, birds, snakes. The red mangrove and the white mangrove has a tannic substance, right, and that they give a color, a red color to the water, and in the bottom is black, always black.
It's amazing, the color of the water, although it's much darker, reminds me of the type of lakes that we find in, say, the northern prairies, like in Alberta or Saskatchewan in Canada. And there are some lakes where when you put your hand in the water, you can't see more than 2 or 3 inches because it's so dark and tannic colored, and this is exactly what it reminds me of. We've come right close to shore to a termite mound that's right on the section of mangrove here. And our guide has just pulled a piece of the mangrove tree off, and it is literally crawling, as you can see, all over his hands with termites. And termites are a very interesting insect. And what can you tell me about the nest itself and how it's made?
Termites is one of the colony animals. We have the bees, the ants, and they eat good from the trees. We consider as cleaning of the forest.
Yeah.
They clean the forest. For example, when some tree fall down and is dead, they eat all the good and clean the land and let other trees grow again.
We just took one little piece of bark off of this tree and look how many termites there. Can you imagine how many are inside that nest?
Millions
of them.
And there is a queen, soldiers,
yep.
And workers.
That's right. And this is one nest.
One nest.
In this monstrous mangrove forest. I can't believe it.
Before you head outdoors, make sure you have everything you need for a successful and enjoyable trip, like these great items available at your friendly neighborhood Walmart store.
Every fisherman should realize the importance of using a good quality fishing line. Berkeley Trilene XL is a super strong monofilament line that gives you maximum strength and thin line diameter. This means you get more sensitivity along with abrasion resistance to make sure you land the big ones.
Walmart. We sell for less every day.
My favorite memory is he used to always put me up on his shoulders. I would say, Dad, he wants this cool movie with me. Dad, can I go outside with you and help you work? I miss him with all my heart. And I miss him a lot.
After almost 20 years, Tomo's Mopeds are back. Finally, fun and affordable transportation for all ages. So simple to operate, you don't even need a motorcycle license. Tomo's Mopeds are ideal for high school, college, and university students. The perfect vehicle for RVers and a great alternative to the bus. And with up to 120 miles per gallon, they're also a great way to fight rising fuel prices. Enjoy the freedom and independence of a Tomo's Moped today. Call or visit our website for the dealer nearest you.
To develop successfully, children need love, attention, and financial support from both parents. Child support allows our child to continue developing with confidence and security. Children come first.
A message from the Government of Canada.
Interesting fact about the mangrove, if you look at my right hand here, your left, you'll see a very young seed or fruit from the tree, and you'll notice that it has a stem or a shoot that's come out of it. This one here, it would have the ability to start a brand new tree, and you can see the succession into my left hand. Once this one finds some ground and gets a hold of the ground and starts to get a shoot out, it'll end up looking like this. And you notice that this particular one in my left hand is already starting to sprout leaves, and it's already growing into a tree. What's neat about this seed pod on in my right hand is that it can float in the water for a great length of time before it finds ground and the shoot or the root is able to take hold. So that's why they end up traveling great distances, and you get pockets of mangroves all over the place. They're just so versatile, aren't they?
Yes. They can float for a long time and land them somewhere and start to grow the forest mangrove.
Now, Hector, a lot of people in North America are very familiar with ferns. It's a very popular plant that people are planting in their gardens, and you see them in a lot of wild areas.
But it's the biggest fern that you can find. We have ferns like trees,
right,
in the mountains,
right,
with a trunk like a palm tree. But this one is the biggest.
And it's neat when you look at a fern and you take the leaves and you turn them over. This is where all the seed pods are in ferns. And those seeds will leave the leaves, and that's how you get such spreading of ferns.
Yes,
just incredible,
yes,
the way that they can spread. Now, Hector and I were just having a discussion whether this was a hemipteran or a homopteran.
Homoptera.
And it's homoptera. And this is known as a stink bug. We have these back in Canada, although they're probably a third of this size. That's a big one. And if I bother it enough, he's going to stink me. But I want to turn it over because they have the long proboscis on the inside,
mm-hmm,
and which they crawl around on plants and they stick that proboscis into plants, and that's where they get their nutrients.
Oh, they don't bite you.
No, they don't bite us.
Yes, they have a bad smell.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they are scared.
They let it rip.
Yes, spread.
I haven't bugged them enough yet.
Ha!
The mangrove tunnels were truly spectacular. The best part was when our guide, who by the way was a very experienced operator, at least that's what Hector said, had the boat up on plane and was cruising through the tunnels. Now this excursion cost about $15 Canadian. It was the cheapest thrill ride of my life, and without a doubt, one of the best. Whoa! Watch that head!
Wow, what a spectacular day, eh?
You
Hector?
Like it?
Oh man, I tell you what. So one thing about being in Cuba that I think is interesting is when you're on the coast with all that salt water, everything's like an ocean playground, but you come here, it's like being in a freshwater lake. It's just outstanding.
Wet land between.
Well, after spending the whole day with Hector, I can honestly say that I had a much better appreciation for Cuba's beautiful landscape and the type of scenery that you might miss if you just stayed at the resort. Hey, but speaking of the resort, it was nice to be on the way back. And word has it that Mia Cayo Coco has a little something else to offer. How about a little Cuban nightlife?
Happening at this point, but we should be leaving right. I mean, the leader should be gone by now, but the waiter is some sorry saps like us to go along and put some trail in for him, yeah. And they're gonna wait, and they're gonna wait. But the speeds we go at, they're gonna be a little disappointed before too long. They're gonna catch up and go, oh,
they need to wait about 4 hours if they think they're gonna catch us by over.
We're a little short on gas by about 2 miles.
Let's splash of the
ruby, or 4 minutes. Burr, I'm cold!
Stay with
it. Yeah, we're
out of gas.
Poor man.
Did you
get it? Yeah, about 3 miles. I was having too much fun. Being done.
Trail's fun in there when it's
Man! I've never seen it like that.
Boom!
Just boom! It's gone. It's like groom trail.
Yeah.
Hey, stay.
Try to see how to get it.
Stay on the trail.
Thank you, guys. Take it easy.
See ya.
That's that.
Thanks for joining the tour. Remember our website, and until next time, safe riding.